So glad you could come to everyone's favorite place for live video, tips, tricks, and tutorials. Welcome to this edition of Learn to Live Stream with Miss Ileane. Hello friends, Ileane Smith here. I did an Instagram story and I promised that I was going to review a few of the apps that I've been using and testing over the past couple of weeks. Well, you guys here on the page have seen me use an app called Ecamm Live. This is a Mac app that I'm going to show you, which is Ecamm Live. And this app that I'm using for the demo is Switcher Go, which is also for iOS only. Okay, so with that said, sorry for the inconvenience for Android folks. Watch anyway, because at least when you see somebody doing or using these tools, you'll know exactly what they're using. So with that said, I gotta turn things around. And so I better put my glasses on. Okay, so right now I'm just showing my screen here. And I'm over on my ileanesmith.com website. You guys know I have two websites, two blogs. Basic Blog Tips is one, and then ileanesmith.com. So I just wanted to have this one up for the purposes of the demo. Now, before I start Ecamm Live, I want to just bring your attention to something. For one thing, I have a very messy desktop. I'm trying to show you the cleaner side of it. All right, on the Mac, you can change your image that you have. Well, same way on PC. And right now I have this lovely mountain range image there. This is all nice and clear because I have a big 27-inch iMac. So this looks lovely. However, on this side, everything is oh so messy. So when you're using Ecamm Live, guys, you want to clean off your desktop. So if you have a Mac, you're going to want to install a little app that's called Hidden Me Free. All right, so that's step one. The next thing you want to do is go and change that desktop. So I want to change my desktop preferences now. All right, so I'm going over to System Preferences. It's a little off the screen, but here we go. Let me move that in the middle so you can see what I'm doing here. And I'm going to change my desktop and screensaver, and I'm going to say I want it as a solid color. This is just going to make it look a little bit better. And so now I have a completely white desktop, okay? Over on the very far right is where I have all of my toolbar, taskbar items, but that's okay. You're not going to be seeing those. All right, so now we're ready to launch the Ecamm Live app. So now I'm launching it, and it's automatically screen sharing. Okay, but we can turn that off. And now you're seeing me. Of course, there's a little bit of a delay lag between me using the app and me using the Ecamm Live desktop. But I wanted you to see this app and see how beautiful it is. So let me do this. Let me bring things over. And one of the things that I like about this Ecamm Live app is that I can have my logo here. So that's just a piece of artwork that I've brought into the frame. Let me move things up a little. And in order for us to see things a little bit more clearly, I'm going to do two things here. I'm going to close out my website, or actually I'm going to just minimize it. Okay, and so now you see I have the blank white screen. And so now I'm going to go back to the screen share, and you're just going to see the white screen. But you at the very top left-hand side, you'll see what I'm going to show you in the menu of Ecamm Live. So see how I have the logo there? And if I wanted to, I believe I can move that around. Let's do that first. Now see, I'm up in the menu here, and I'm going to, there's two options. One says overlay bigger or overlay smaller. So let's make it smaller. See, just nudged it down just a little. Let's make it bigger, and I'm going to make it even bigger in case you didn't see how much bigger it got. So here I could have a different item. Let's just say I didn't want the Ileane Smith logo. There was one that I used previously, which was basic blog tips. So there, now you see that at the bottom left-hand side. Okay, the next thing you wanna always make sure that it's picking up the right microphone. So in my case, whenever I go live from my desktop, I wanna use this ATR mic. Let's lift that up so you guys can see that option there at the top. For the camera here, where my options are here, instead of the FaceTime camera, I always like to go live with my HD Pro webcam. So it'll pick up what other cameras you have installed on your system. Here I could do the camera. This is the source. I could do camera, screen share, or video file. Yes, I can actually bring in a video. So let's do that because I think that's really fancy. Now I also could type text, but before I do that, let me get rid of the video. Go back to screen share. Up at the top right, you guys can barely see it. Let me lift up the phone. I have the phone on a tripod, by the way. There's a type text tool. Here, of course, we would change the color of that text. And my keyboard is too awkward for me to reach behind right now, so let's just pretend I wanted to add that as the text. All right. And then I can move that around. Also, I can move my logos around wherever I want to position them on screen. Okay, so now, if I want to do picture in picture, I'm going to go up to the Ecamm Live menu, and I'm going to go over to options. And there you'll see the option there for show picture in picture. And so there I am. Now, I can move that picture and picture around. So of course I would move it over here where the white space is, or to cover up my little taskbar menu over on the side. Okay. We have so many options today for live streaming. Ecamm Live is a fantastic option where you can do the picture in picture. You can have your logo displayed. You can bring in multimedia as well as videos. So I'm hoping that you're going to take this opportunity to explore live video. And if you want more of these types of tips, subscribe to the channel, but also consider becoming a patron over on Patreon. And that's patreon.com/Ileane. I'll see you in the next video. Take care and have a great day.